Oh, look, this houses the blooded dice.
I know.
What are these doing here?
It looked decorative.
We don't need dice to make
I know, characters. That's the funny part.
Hey, everybody, it's Sean. This is the legend Jesse Foster. This is Chris. And we are making GURPS Illuminati characters today for the 31-day character challenge. Chris, have you read the Illuminati trilogy?
I have not.
You have not? No. Okay. Jesse, have you read the Illuminati trilogy?
You're not clear for that.
Okay. There we go. Actually, I'm going to move the camera just a little bit. So yeah, we're going to make GURPS Illuminati characters. And I brought Jesse in on this because he is the master of GURPS. And said not
close enough.
Is it close enough? Okay.
If there was a master of GURPS.
If there was a master of GURPS.
It would be.
Okay.
So.
You don't have your fez.
I don't have a fez. I have a handmade fez. It's not quite the same.
Oh, okay.
I have the shirt. I don't need a fez.
Okay, that's true. If you don't know what GURPS is, it's not a role-playing game. It's a disease. And your favorite game can catch it.
All right, I'm out.
And we also have Tally here, who is off camera, but she's always present.
She will likely be on camera at some point.
We're rambunctious and will likely be on the table before the night's out.
Yeah, that's true. You don't roll dice to make GURPS characters.
I know.
You roll dice to annoy John.
Yep.
So GURPS Illuminati is one of my favorite GURPS books. And I loved the third edition GURPS source books. I think they're all fantastic. Ken Haidt has this genius idea of if you're struggling for a campaign, you just randomly pull two GURPS books off the shelf.
Right.
So you get like GURPS Atlantis and GURPS Vikings.
Mm-hmm. I'll play that game.
Yeah. It's it's fantastic.
Yep, I ran that at a con once. I pulled Atlantis, World War II, and GURPS Mars.
Oh, wow.
So I put a gateway in Atlantis to Mars for you know, a sunken sub to go to.
That's, wow.
It was a lot of fun.
That sounds like a lot of fun.
So in GURPS, you have four. What are the four stats in GURPS?
Four primary attributes are strength, dexterity, IQ, and health.
Okay. And it's a point-based system, so we're not going to be rolling dice to
make characters. Right, that's why you keep giving me crap about it.
That's why I keep giving you crap about it. Jesse, how many points are we going to make our characters with today?
100.
100 points? That's a standard GURPS character, right?
I'd say about 150, but we're newbies to the Illuminati world, so
we're
not going to know a lot.
All right, so...
yet to be illuminated.
We have, and hopefully we'll never be illuminated, right? I was thinking about making a character who... has just encountered the Discordian Society.
Okay.
Right. And the Discordian Society and GURPS Illuminati are the anti-conspiracy. They're the ones who are trying to keep the Bavarian Illuminati and the gnomes of Zurich and all of the others from taking complete control. Right. So I want to play a Discordian secret agent.
Okay.
So that's the character I want to make.
All right.
Just trying to track all that.
Should be taking notes.
Yeah.
You should be taking notes.
I did. You didn't see it?
I didn't.
You can't read this?
That says a lot.
So Steve Jackson is really interesting with the whole Illuminati thing, because I think he plays it, he either deliberately or accidentally plays it so right, because I have no idea if he believes all of it or believes none of it.
Right.
Right. And I think it's perfect the way that he pulls it off.
And having met him, spent time with him, I completely agree.
Yeah. So GURPS Illuminati is based on the Illuminatus trilogy and other stuff, but primarily Illuminatus trilogy by Robert Anton Wilson and Robert Shea. And in it, in the Illuminatus trilogy, they were editors for Playboy magazine in the 60s. And they kept getting all of this hack mail, is what they were calling it, which was people going, I know the secret truth of the world. I know who's in charge of this, and I know who's in charge of this. And they would get all of it. And one day they just decided, you know what? We should write a book. And so they wrote The Eye in the Pyramid, I think, is the first Illuminatus book. The Eye in the Pyramid. And in it, they were handing the book off to each other, back and forth. The goal was to convince the reader every few pages that the plot up to this point is wrong, That's not what's going on. This is what's going on. Okay. And so they would hand it back and forth to each other and just undermine each other. That it was almost fun. Like a PvP novel. At one point, the Bavarian Illuminati of Adam Weishaupt and all of the, you know, the they're controlling everything. And then, no, it's the assassins. And then, no, it's the gnomes from Zurich. And then, no, it's the so-and-so. And the only consistent thing in the entire book is the Discordian Society, who are trying to prevent the various Illuminati from... And they have a golden submarine.
Oh. Of course. What if that came from Atlantis?
I don't know. It could have.
It may have.
I mean, it, depending on whose turn it is to write the book.
Right.
You said you wanted to make someone who has just encountered the Illuminati. The,
yeah. Has just been recruited into the Discordian Society.
The Discordian Society. Okay. So what did they do before that?
I think that I'm going to play along with type, and I'm going to say that they were an editor for a conspiracy magazine.
That makes sense.
Oh, nice.
And just by chance, and a total skeptic, right? A complete skeptic. Like, none of this, all of this is bullshit, right? But they published something, and these two men in black suits showed up and said, we need to have a talk with you.
Ooh. About what you just wrote.
About what you just wrote. He made a break for it and bumped into the Discordian Society.
Oh, okay.
So I think that's what my character is going to be.
All right. I think I might revise what I said earlier. We should maybe go with 200 points. So we have a little bit of skill behind us. So
200 points?
Yes.
Oh, wow. That's a big GURPS character.
He probably also knows that I was at the table, and eventually I'll complain.
Yes. Anything under 300, we can't get Chris at the table.
Yeah, it's difficult.
So, although we are using GURPS Illuminati, this is a third edition
book.
It is. And you have the fourth edition rules.
Yes. Okay. So we're going to make fourth edition characters.
Yeah.
The book, like most third edition books, is 80 to 90% information.
Yeah.
And not character attributes or game system things. It's easily adaptable to most other game systems and, of course, specifically to GURPS 4th edition.
Right. Yeah.
So you're going to make a character who was an editor, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So they're probably fairly smart.
Yeah.
Not overly strong or...
No.
Dexterous.
No. Or healthy.
Possibly reasonably healthy.
Because eating ramen in the office.
Yeah, if you eat like a traditional editor.
Yeah. Depends on how much of a stereotype you want to play.
Either that or IT. One of the two.
All right. No, so, to start with, looking at your basic attributes. Points-wise, you've got 200 points.
It depends on...
Your strength and your health cost 10 points per level.
Okay.
Your dex and your IQ cost 20 points per level. They all start at 10.
Okay.
The average generic everyday human starts at 10.
So if you... Yeah, you just add points and put the number you want. I think I was going to be either one of your reporters.
Okay.
Maybe planted by the Discordians to watch you.
Wow. So are you going to increase any of your attributes?
Yeah, I think
probably
I'm going to...
Smarter than average?
I'm going to be smarter than average. What would you recommend for a smarter than average character?
For starting where we're what we're talking about, I would say 13.
13, okay.
I was thinking that.
So that's 60 points, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And the bracketed spot here is for points.
Okay. That's a lot of my 200 points.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you're smart.
Yeah, I am smart.
IQ and dex primarily will feed all of your skills.
Okay,
so having
yeah.
high IQ will feed all your mental skills, all your
that's
all
right.
knowledge-based skills.
That's right, because my int-based or my IQ skills will have my IQ.
Yeah, the IQ plus something.
Plus
usually.
Something, yeah.
So since you're going with a reporter-type character, your skill set seems a lot like John's.
Yeah, I just put a little bit higher dex.
Right.
Probably out in the field operating things.
A little more
actually
physical,
more
functional.
Tech stuff that I have to deal with. Depending on the year we're of play, we change what kind of tech, but other than that.
So I'll ask for a little bit of input on this, but to balance out how mental the two of you are, so to speak... I was going to go with someone a little more physical. So,
okay.
Somebody works in the warehouse, or you know, if you're affluent enough, your driver or someone like that that's in the employ but would be well served as a bodyguard or something of that nature should the situation turn.
There's a whole bunch of woo in the martial arts community. So I'm going to throw this at you. This
okay.
is, and you can take it. You're like... totally into the, you're like the James Randi of the martial arts. Like you go, like in your hat, you know, you're, you know, you work in the warehouse.
We're talking about my character, right?
Yeah, we're talking about,
right.
Oh yeah, that too.
I know, you go Master Ken on this one, too.
Oh, dude. And shout out to Master Ken.
Shout out to Master Ken.
I really like that idea that you go around and people are like, oh, I have chi powers and I can make my whole dojo fall down by just me pointing at them. And you show up and go, try me.
Yeah, I'll do it. I'll do
it. So, something we didn't talk about since we didn't discuss a lot of the details around this this game we're all making a character for is what era are we in?
So
modern day, or we want to push it back to like 20s, 30s, 40s, or?
Well, the original books came out in the 60s and 70s. So we could do that. We could do like that era, or we could do a modern era. I'm good with either one.
I think earlier would be better. Earlier era would be better.
Earlier era.
So you want to do like a 70s, like a 70s thing? Because that'd be kind of cool.
Yeah.
70s would be
comparing good. The music to Shaft.
Also, the 70s is when a lot of that there was a ton of all the woo stuff running around.
The martial arts surge in America.
Yep, because Bruce Lee.
Yeah, because Bruce Lee.
Because Bruce Lee.
I'm going to work out some of my attributes here. Probably looking at a 14 for dex, but might bring that down to a 13, a little more reasonable.
Yeah, I went with a 12.
Since my dexterity is going to be my driving attribute for martial arts skills.
Mm-hmm.
Even if I don't go that route, I may go more of a boxer, but a really tough guy that, you know, people come at him doing their flips and kicks and he just, you know, Hellboy punches him in the face.
That works.
I like that a lot.
Which means he might be more stronger than he is dexterous.
So I'm not the Illuminati guy here, other than the card game. I don't have a lot of experience with it.
Yeah.
Is there actually supernatural stuff in, if you had an Illuminati campaign?
Everything is true.
Yes, everything is true.
Even false things.
Even false things. Are true. So there isn't, but there is.
Yes.
Even things that contradict each other.
Yeah.
Okay.
Remember, every few pages.
Yes. Good point. Okay, got it.
Do you guys keep talking? I want to finish my character.
Right.
You're going to finish your character. Yeah. There's a stealth skill, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Because you got to get into places that they don't expect you to be.
Yeah, as an editor?
Yeah. Well, I used to be a reporter.
Right.
I inherited this after the original editor.
Yeah.
He disappeared.
Oh, so, after the two guys showed up.
Yeah, after the two guys showed up.
I'm definitely taking photography. I'll take shadowing in addition to stealth.
Oh, okay.
So I can follow people without them knowing I'm following them.
If you're trying to negotiate things, diplomacy would be good.
Yeah.
If you're trying to bullshit somebody, fast talk is good.
Which I just wrote that down.
I don't believe you.
No, see, it's right here.
Yeah, you convinced me.
I'm a compulsive liar, you believe me?
I do. Every time.
Compulsive liar. Not just for years I've been saying that. Yeah. I'm a compulsive liar, do you believe me? Just to see what people say.
So I'm thinking that one of his quirks is likes people.
Likes people.
Yeah.
Yeah. Does that qualify?
As a quirk, not really. It doesn't really limit your character in any way. So a quirk should have...
Trusts people.
There you go.
So that's definitely a limitation.
What are you taking?
I like that you're making another non-combat character, Chris.
I know.
You're stretching.
Stretching my powers. Yes.
What are you making?
I'm making a fighter so far.
Combat character.
So high dexterity, decent strength, high pain threshold, so when it gets hit, it doesn't slow him down. Sort of with brawling, but I'm mostly helping you guys and writing down the occasional thing when I can.
What's that on your advantages?
High pain threshold.
Okay. There we go.
When you get hit, you don't get the penalties for pain.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a 60-point advantage in this book called Illuminated.
Yeah, I'm not taking that.
You have undergone a mystical experience which has made you one of the Illuminati in the original sense. You are enlightened. You know what's going on. Depending on the campaign, you don't necessarily have to be a member of an Illuminated organization. The organizations are a means to make one an Illuminatus. Blah, 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 text, blah, blah, blah. As an Illuminated character, you gain the advantages of luck, 30 points.
Dang.
And intuition. In addition, you gain the ability to mystically discern another Illuminati on sight with no possibility of error. On a successful IQ roll, you can even tell if the Illuminati are behind certain events or situations. This perception has nothing to do with logical deduction. You just read the morning newspaper and know that Dow drops 50 points is part of an Illuminati plot.
Right. So that explains the dog-faced woman abducted by giant space elves on the back.
Yes.
So you're saying that's something that you're not going to have because you haven't been illuminated yet.
I'm tempted to take it.
It's a chunk of points.
It's 60 points.
Yeah.
But it's really handy.
Right, but you get that way you get like, you get intuition, which basically allows the GM to tell you stuff.
Yeah.
That you normally probably wouldn't know as a character. It's like you just get this idea that maybe that's not right. And being able to see Illuminati stuff.
There's also a disadvantage called weirdness magnet.
Oh, yeah.
I have had that one. It's fun.
Yes.
The world's only talking dog sits down to talk to you about his problems.
Yeah. In my games, I tend to disallow it.
Yeah.
Because everybody in the party
has a weirdness magnet.
Because if there's a talking dog in the world, it'll come talk to the party.
Yeah. Yeah. You already have it. So it has to get strange.
So as the GM, would you let me take Illuminated?
I think that would change the game a lot.
Yeah.
I think it might be better. If you want to take it, take it. But I would say...
could I take a 30-point version of it?
You could take the advantages it lists in there. Like, yeah. You don't already have luck and...
Intuition. Which I think
are not have the ability 40.
To know what is... Okay.
Since the Illuminated... That's what I would start with. And that way, when you do get it, when you are awakened as an Illuminated individual,
yeah, mechanically
you'll have luck. Some of the points already committed.
Yeah, mechanically, luck just gives you rerolls, basically. Yeah.
Covers accounting, administration, economics, finance, gambling, market analysis, merchant, and propaganda. End of the peak hours half. We got a message from the Illuminati.
Yeah, we did. What did she say?
I didn't hear all of it.
I didn't catch it either.
That seems...
It's usually mysterious and...
And it makes no sense. You
know, not quite knowable.
Unless you're Illuminated.
Need a good name for a magazine.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Gazetteer or Gazette or... You don't want it to sound completely trashy, but...
No.
Close.
Yeah. Semi-respectful.
You could do something, play off of the Illuminate word. Since we're close to it, we could be fringing on or... Have a name similar to
Illuminews.
Yeah.
Illuminews. Oh, wow.
It just came out. I'll go back to rolling dice. Sorry, guys.
Yeah, I'm going to roll dice for your character. The Daily Enlightened or something like that. So it's suggesting something illuminated, but even though, you know, we're not.
Because we don't buy any of that crap.
Right.
Just cranks come in, they send us stuff and we publish it because it
makes money.
Yeah,
because people buy papers.
I don't know, cost that newspaper.
How about the I was gonna say something like The Guiding Light, but that's a show.
That is a show.
Yeah,
it's not a bad name for a magazine though.
No, it's not. Paper. It's really good.
It has some religious overtones to it though.
Broken Lantern News. The lanterns sound interesting too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think the lighthouse.
The lighthouse having a symbol like that.
I like the lighthouse.
The lighthouse.
Yeah. Okay. I also like the movie, but that's different.
Lighthouse Chronicle.
No, just the lighthouse.
The lighthouse. All right, yeah. So that's where it is.
Yeah. Shining the light.
Shining the light.
Yeah.
Well, here she comes.
I'm gonna take a patron.
Yeah.
That's it. You know, since I'm undercover and all that.
Oh yeah.
So and I'm a patron.
You'll need secret as well.
I will need secret.
Because it could be a problem if it comes
That's a disadvantage.
Out.
Secret patron.
No, the patron may not be secret.
Oh, but there's a in this book, there's a secret patron, which is you buy it and the GM knows what it is.
No, I want to know who it is. Okay. I know who it is. But the fact that I have a patron
is secret.
Because I'm not telling you that I work for that I work for them.
Oh, okay.
I'm watching you.
With Winston's line.
Yeah?
Yeah. Does it say paycheck in it? I'll believe anything you want.
It costs us through the nose, but we make sure that our employees are covered.
Hey, 401k, 402k, whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Same movie references I can get into one time.
Right.
So there is a conspiracy theory skill.
Yeah.
Ooh, a skill.
Defaults to history -4 or occultism -4.
Oh, occultism.
It's the study of interlocking network of conspiracies that has been created by the Illuminati. They can conspiracy theorists can answer questions about the conspiratorial view of history, the various groups thought to be behind the assassination of Kennedy or the French Revolution. Does not automatically give the character knowledge about how the conspiracy works. However, conspiracy theorists can sometimes determine whether a certain strange occurrence is truly coincidence or the result of the conspiracy.
Sounds like a skill you would have.
It sounds like a skill I would have.
How about status, since you're a recognized and successful editor.
Yeah.
Maybe you've gained a little status.
And wealth.
Yeah. So status.
They're both
status one.
Right?
Yeah, maybe status one Don't want to go too high.
Maybe comfortable wealth.
And comfortable wealth.
Which is like cool. 10 points, I think.
They go hand in hand, yeah.
Yeah.
And we're back.
We were gone. We were gone.
We were. Or weren't.
Were we gone?
No.
Nothing is different.
Nothing.
Nothing has changed. Everything's the same.
It's all the same.
What you saw was the planet Venus.
That's right.
You didn't see
swamp gas.
Swamp gas.
Swamp gas. Oh, I love the swamp gas one.
Yeah. Okay, so where are we at? I think that I have everything that I want on my character sheet.
So, can the character do any fighting?
I don't think so.
Okay.
One of the characters I was thinking about doing was a revisionist historian.
Yeah.
Who actually goes back in time and makes revisions to history. And
actually revises history.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
Asshole time traveler from the future.
The other one I was thinking about doing was the mimetic weapon.
Yeah.
Is someone who...
Oh.
have you seen Wag the Dog?
Yes.
A long time.
Love that movie.
And essentially they invented a war to distract everyone from the president. That character.
Hmm.
I want to make that guy.
The dog, the tail wagger.
The tail wagger, yeah.
Or the dog wagger.
Yeah.
Wag the dog. Dog wagger. What other country are we in?
Throw out suggestions.
I'm assuming we're in America.
Yeah. San Francisco.
Pick a big city. San Francisco.
Yeah. Right.
Oh, that's a good one. I like that one.
That'll brew up a lot of trouble for me then.
Why is that?
I've got an intolerance toward all that karate nonsense.
Oh, that's right.
So, a lot of... of immigration, a lot of enclaves of different cultures mixing in San Francisco.
Yeah, you got a lot of different martial arts forms there.
Yeah, a lot of...
That's where Bruce Lee
really was. Cool
seems like for a while.
Upswing of martial arts and everything. And I'm out there being, like jackass American about it. Yeah, I actually took intolerance of karate nonsense. So you start talking, internal forms and chakras and chi, and I'm like,
get out of here.
Shut up.
Get out of here.
Shut up.
Here's a good right cross.
Yeah. You know what you need? Uppercut.
Uppercut.
Light sleeper. He's working all the time, so it doesn't get
I think
sleep.
He's addicted to caffeine.
I was going
to
say, he's going to have some addictions maybe. So,
addicted to caffeine and nicotine.
Okay. Overweight, underweight.
Like, oh, skinny. He's definitely underweight.
Okay. Definitely underweight. Skinny's a disadvantage.
Skinny.
Makes it hard to buy clothes because they won't quite fit, and it's much easier to knock you down.
Okay.
So I decided, since I'm a man of the street.
Yeah. Okay.
And I apparently like to pick fights with some of the more colorful locals.
You're like Uncle Josh.
I've learned, yeah.
Sorry.
He's always picking fights with the animals, though.
Mm.
I'm picking fights with the
That's right.
With the locals. So I picked up a little bit of Mandarin along the way. Just enough probably to be rude, know a few bad words. I do a little bit of Japanese and a little bit of Spanish. So when I'm out in the streets, I can, make out a word or two.
Think about knowing Spanish.
If I wasn't such an asshole, I'd probably have learned karate by now.
Hey, you have an arc.
I'm trying to not make him a bully, but he's a bit of a bully right now.
You have an arc.
Yeah.
You have room to grow.
I have plenty of room to
serious
grow.
To grow.
Huge arc ahead of me. Yes.
So 144. I'm 144 point character.
I'm at 113 right now.
Cool. It's a good place to be. Could round it up to 150. I know we're working with 200, but we can pick an earlier stopping point.
Yeah, we can pick a. I think 150 might be good. It yeah, feels
pretty close.
It
feels, to that.
Feels like he's pretty much done.
Yeah.
Might grab another advantage. So it's a. I forgot which one it was. Ooh, Daredevil.
I get points for doing crazy shit.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Well, you spend points on it. It's 15 points. And anytime you take an unnecessary risk, you get a bonus of 1 to all your skill rolls for it. And you can reroll a critical failure that occurs during high risk behavior. So I'm a reporter. I go and get into places I shouldn't.
And the more I talk about him, the more he sounds like a Joe. And I'm pretty close to the same point level you are at this point.
Cool.
So I'm, other than a little bit of fine-tuning, Joe's pretty much done. A little bit of experience with guns, a little bit of experience with knives, a little bit of experience with hiding stuff on his person, because he's been to a few of the shadier places in town, worked as a bouncer, worked as a doorman, worked as a bodyguard, and has now ended up in a situation with you guys. A couple of reporters. Maybe the reporters are going in somewhere a little more dangerous than usual and know they need backup, and they know Joe from the local pub.
So I what I think is that we knew Joe from local pub, right? Because it's the 1970s. We're, you know, I'm an editor, he's a reporter. That means that some point between 12 p.m. and 5 p.m., we're going to be in the bar.
Going to be drinking.
Yeah. We're going to be drinking.
Did they have pubs in the 70s?
They didn't have internet. Of course they had pubs.
I think that the Men in Black showed up, and we had to, like, get the hell out of the... And there was an incident.
Yeah.
Right? And I decided, okay, we need somebody in the building.
Right.
Let's go hire Joe.
Right. My name's Marco Pascal.
Wow, nice Pascal.
Or so you know. How much of it is a cover?
Right.
I think because it's San Francisco and he's an editor, I think his name is William Twain.
William Twain. Yep. Like it, Will Twain.
Yep.
Nice.
For food.
Leaning towards Dorman for last name, but it was a little too on the nose.
Joe so Dorman?
I just went with Drummond. So it's a nice, calm, unassuming name.
I dig it. So we work for the Lighthouse newspaper, which is like one of the free newspapers in the 70s, like the LA Free, our LA.
Oh, is it like the New Times here?
Yeah, like the New Times. Yeah,
that's
and we make money off of advertising, and all the advertising is all of the crank. All the crank publishers that are making like omnibooks and things like that.
Wow.
And then the Men in Black showed up, started asking questions, and then we hired
Joe Drummond, former bouncer for the Rusty Nail.
I
love that bar.
Awesome.
Yeah, a lot of print guys hang out there.
I like our characters.
All right, I just need to get a gun and a nice leather coat, and I'm ready to go.
I can find you one.
Nice leather coat.
Yes.
Yeah. Awesome.
That's on this side.
Oh, that
equipment.
That's on this side. Oh, look, the Illuminati are on the character sheet.
Yeah. They know.
They gave us permission to use the sheet too.
Oh, that's good. That's good. They're on the character sheet. So those are our characters.
They're somewhere else too.
Yeah. They're those are our characters for GURPS Illuminati. For what is today?
The 13th?
13th, no.
Is it?
Yeah, is it? Friday was the 10th.
It's the 13th.
It's 13th. Oh, Monday the 13th.
Monday.
Worse than Friday the 13th. And
depending on what you ate.
Thanks, Jesse, for helping us make GURPS characters.
Of course, anytime.
Yeah. And thanks, Chris, for showing up. Awesome. Do all the things I tell you to do. Wash your hands, wear a mask, get the shot, and take care of each other. And most importantly, trust no one.
Keep your laser handy. Wait, sorry, wrong game.
Wrong game.